confirmed reports of an accident at Southland Park.
Hundreds of family members gathered outside the deserted park today to commemorate the second anniversary of the
full investigation of the park's safety.
Authorities report at least 30 deaths and close to 100 injuries.
5 years since the tragedy closed the gates of Southland Park, but new evidence
is claiming malicious prosecution and believes he'll be vindicated at last.
Every penny of his fortune defending himself from these lawsuits,
defending Southland Park over Joe.
There were people flying everywhere. It was body parts.
And the victims' families have vowed to appeal the decision.
Not guilty.
Cleared of all charges.
This training level will introduce to you.
Welcome to the States, 47. This should be a straightforward operation. We need you to penetrate an abandoned amusement park, locate the owner, and take him out. The target is a Joseph Clarence, also known as Swing King. An accident involving one of the rides at the park a few years back forced him to close it down. Our client has made a special request that the photograph you have in your possession be the last thing the target sees. Mr. Clarence has somehow become involved with a narcotics distribution ring, so the park may still have some amusements. Enjoy the ride, 47.
What the fuck you looking at, cracker?
I'm here to see Joseph Clarence.
Never heard of
him. Mr. Swing King?
Oh, that sorry ass dickhead. What the fuck they call you?
Names are for friends, so I don't need one.
Nope. I can get the money, sweetie. It's as good as mine already. Mr. Spook's got it. We'll open the park. It'll be like old times. No, just a few more days. You gotta believe me. Don't say that, Sunshine. Mr. Spook's gonna come true, baby. He's good for the money. I won't sign the papers. I won't. You gotta give me one more chance. You gotta. Baby cakes? Sunshine? Hello? It's been a while now, Scoop, and I was just wondering where we were on the whole money thing.
Were you?
Yeah, see, the thing is, if you remember, you know what we agreed to was it'd just be a short while and you'd pay in cash, and I know the pressures you were under must be, but the deal is a deal, and I was hoping, you know, maybe you could just pay what we agreed on, even though you've been here for, heck, more than twice as long as we agreed to, but just pay the original amount and move on. Not right away, necessarily, but, you know, I'd appreciate it.
No. who's unwrapping me.
God damn, girl. I'd have your fine ass unwrapped before you could say, "Who's that handsome stud on time my ribbon?"
I bet you could. So, that's Uncle Joe. Better get back to your post.
Suffering I'm responsible for? I can't sleep. I haven't slept in the guilt I feel. I'm so sorry. I know I can never. I can see it in your eyes. You're not a bald man, the bad man. You can't just kill me. Please. God, no!
Thank you. Rick Henderson, first edition.
He's expecting you. This way.
Rick Henderson. I've been looking forward to this.
As have I, Mr. Alexander.
Don't let's stand on ceremony. Call me Jack.
Rick.
Make yourself comfortable, Rick. I'll be right with you.
I admire your work. Real journalism.
Thanks. I thought we'd start with your thoughts on the White House attack, then discuss your tenure as director of the FBI, post-retirement reflections, whatever, and...
Rick.
Or if you want to sound off on politics...
Rick, my apologies. This interview about me is just a cover for a more sensitive story. I'm sorry to have lured you here under false pretenses, but I couldn't risk a leak.
I'm not sure I understand.
Don't worry. It's the scoop of the century.
If I had a dime for every time I heard that...
Listen, please. It begins with a little incident at a vineyard in Chile that caught my eye some time ago. This was a family business. Fernando Delgado and his son Manuel. Well-liked, hard-working men. Have a look at the folder.